few things that make traveling less inviting here in China is it's the huge security. There's like a huge amount of control of all the baggage, and also the tickets are controlled like 2 times before you even go into the train. So that makes it less attractive. But we went through that already. I'm surprised that they didn't pull me over because I'm foreigner and I have a lot of stuff like camera gear in my bag. So we're gonna jump on the train. See ya. Why are all these people watching me?
Hi. Hi. Ni hao.
So this trip is going to Luoyang. My boss invited me there. And we're gonna go on a night train actually, on 2 ones today, tonight, and then going back to Bangu. This will be tomorrow, so we're gonna have maybe 12 hours in the city. This was one of the 4 old capitals of China. These are the tickets, and I think it's gonna be a very interesting experience to say the least to go on a night train in China. Let's see how it looks.
This is like minuscule, but I think it's possible to sleep. It looks kind of hygienic, so I think there's just this snorkeling. What is it called? The sound you make when you sleep, snorting Chinese right and left. But I think, yeah, I think I'm gonna sleep a few hours.
Our first stop is gonna be the Luoyang Grotts. This is in the city of Luoyang. We just came to the Yi River by bus, and the grots are, the caves are World Heritage Site since 2006. So I would say let's go and check it out.
So these are the caves.
I thought they were like a little bit bigger, that you could actually like really go in most of them, but apparently not, pretty small. But still interesting, it's World Heritage. Sure, let your kids run into World Heritage sites. Yeah, that's how it's done. These are the grots. I thought they were like a little bit deeper, because I mean, when you talk of caves, I think that you should like be able to go in, but actually it's Buddha statues in each one of the holes in this huge rock, so it's kind of cool, but I think the World Heritage Site is not really protected or cherished by the Chinese, because they just let their kids into like the parts where it's closed off actually. So, well, I don't know how long this thing will exist here still, but I'm lucky enough to see it pretty intact yet. And we're lucky to be here on a weekday, so there are not that many people. I think there's still some travel groups, but it's okay. I mean, it's pretty relaxed. I can show you a little bit around. Looks kind of cool. And there's actually some instructions in English too. I'm talking about the people who made this, talking about the scholars and writers and all that good stuff. Looks pretty cool, yeah. I like it, definitely. Here's another set of these caves.
So we're on the bridge, having a huge look on these caves. It looks so great. So I guess that's how it starts. A huge rock, and then they make something genius, and then they get some Buddha statues out of it. That's amazing, out of rock. Say that they're very, very creative and modern here. Instead of a tour guide, they have these signs here that you can like, you can take the QR code, and then on WeChat you get like an explanation. It even talks. It's like a tour guide, so it's better than a tour guide. You just have it on your cell phone. It's perfect. Very ingenious. So there's some things that I don't understand. For example, this villa is built for Song and Jen, like it's written here. But they're actually opponents to the Communist Party. They tried to fight them. So I don't know if that's cultural heritage. I mean, you know, it's the opponents. But this is not okay. This will probably be our last thing to see here in Luoyang. Hello. Scared a woman. This is absolutely cool. The lights just went on. Lightning is so epic on this temple. This is like one of the gatehouses from the city that are still preserved. And it's very well preserved yet, as you can see. It's so amazing. It's so cool. Yeah, unfortunately I think we don't have that much time left, so we're gonna have dinner. Wow, it's huge. This is actually the same shitty location as yesterday, just that I have like the whole apartment just for me, the whole department. So it's gonna be quite a relaxed night, and I think that's the end of the vlog, except anything crazy happens, but I don't think so. Let's see how well I sleep, and it was a great day here in Luoyang. Maybe I don't want to come back, no, it's not that worth it. But it was kind of cool seeing the World Heritage Site. With that, see you on the next vlog.